In this lesson, we will learn how to use the requirements module for managing requirements, test coverage, test execution, and release reporting. We will only work with the requirements module without going into the quality module and managing the structure. So, in this lesson, I will take the role of a tester and will create requirements coverage on specific requirements. So let's go into the requirements module. You can see I don't have any quality module. I can manage everything as a tester in requirements module. Creating test coverage, managing requirements, planning test execution, and even reporting. Let's go into the requirements module. And now you can see I am in the requirements module and I have two areas. One is the outer ring and the other one is manage. Today we will focus on the manage area. In the manage area, I have here the tool for tree. So I can collapse and expand this, and same for the filtering. This will be very important later on for reporting. In the tree, I will focus on the Advantage Online Store application. So you can see it's still context driven. So I've built a hierarchy here with a simple requirement document structure. And this is the requirement I'm going to cover. And we have already implemented release 1.0 of AOS. So you can see release 1.0. If I would want to check the result for release 1.0, I can select it here in the filter, and you can basically see all the defects we had were minimum fixed. A lot of them are closed, proposed closed, and also the test cases we had are green. So release one is deployed and everything was fine. Let's see how it looks like for release two. In release two, we have still some test errors. So in total two errors. And we have few defects opened, three defects opened, and four which are in state new. So let's see how we can now create requirements coverage for release 2.0. Let's go to the requirement which has no test cases. I can see here, invite friends to create an account. Has no test cases, so I have the option on that requirement to use existing test just by adding them. And here I can search for keywords to identify what could be the possible test I could reuse here, or I can directly create a new test. So let's create a new test. Here I need to provide the name of the test. So let's say this is send invitation via email to your friend. This is a acceptance test. This is fine. I can add here application modules. So I can directly link this to application modules. Even I don't see the quality module. This is very important. So my advice would be to link it always to the application module where the test need to be covered from. Even it is a covered test on a requirement, just assign it to the right scope in your application module. And after that, let's click on add and edit. It will directly jump into the step editor and we can quickly write down the script now. So let's see. On the accounts page, click on invite friends button. And now we need to check something. Check dialog for entering friends email is opened. Enter the email and click on send. A notification will occur once the email is sent. A notification will confirm the email is sent. Okay, so let's save this test. So I can see here I have created quickly a test which is now covering my invite friends requirement. So let's plan this test for execution. So I will plan it now also for my user. So let's go here to the release. I will select Alex, and also it is part of the release 2.0. In this context, it should be executed, and that's it. So I can now say plan run, and this is now planned. So let's see how this has an impact on the overall reporting. So let's go back here, go to overview. Now I can see for release 2.0, I have here a test which is planned. So let's go to my test and execute it. View runs. I can click on the run, and directly from here, I can run it. So this is fine. This is fine as well. And okay. So I have executed the test. Let's go back. You can see here it is updated. And also here I have an update on the execution. If I go back, I can see that two test cases are passed and one is failed based on this release. So this was a quick introduction into the requirements module, just to show you that I'm still able to see the heat map in the dashboard, even I don't have the quality module here. You can see the view of my release 2.0. My dashboard is loaded for 2.0, and I can see this heat map. Even I, as a user who is a tester, is not using the quality module. Still, on my test cases and on my defects, I have the attribute application modules, which is assigned, and this makes the difference if you are able to see the heat map or not. The heat map is available only if you are assigning your entities actively to the application modules. Then you are able to see it.